He's open, so is he available for this weekend?
Yes, so the first time he trained together with us was on Wednesday. He had the biggest part of the training session together with us, and yesterday we had to calm him down a bit. And today it was the first session together with the whole team, so the first completely session. To be honest, he's not prepared for playing 90 minutes, but he will travel with us, and he's 100% ready for at least a part-time appearance. And yeah, we're happy to have him back, because although he's perhaps not prepared for 90 minutes, I know, okay, he's a good option for, let's say, the last 30 minutes, and also he's there with his appearance and his role and his leadership in the dressing room, and for that, at least good news with Ivo. Everything's okay. I think it was also important for Dennis, for Anel and for Moritz to have another proper week together with us, and you can see that they from day to day are more settled down, and it's so on and all. So yeah, terrible news with Tom Tribal, but all in all, everything's okay. We had again today 20 field players on the pitch, so a lot of competition, and all in all, a really good situation. The only thing that is a little bit disappointing is the situation with Tom. On all the other terms, personal terms, we're really good in the moment.
I guess much like last week, Johnny didn't turn out to be the story. You hope that's the case tomorrow, and that Cameron isn't the story.
Yes, it is like it is. So, but it's quite known that sometimes players are leaving, and really good lads and guys with a good character. And I think Cam, he did a lot for this club and was there with big success. And I really wish him all the best, and hopefully a really good end of the season and many goals and many appearances, and hopefully he will score a lot. So tomorrow we can take a break. It's no problem. I hope he will. And I'm really glad that he had this first goal for Derby on last weekend. So normally it's the football writes the stories that the first goal is against the old club or whatever. So I'm really happy that he was able to score on last week, and he can go on, but hopefully not tomorrow. We go there pretty respectful, because we know we have an away game at a team who's on position 2 in the table, who's unbeaten in I think 11 league games. Out on a really decent run. It's a team who concedes the lowest number of goals in the whole league. So it's normally the team who plays in the starting lineup with the highest average of age. So a really, really experienced squad. And I think when you watch average age in the starting line, it's close to 30 years. So, you know, all the lads on the pitch know what is important to win some games. They are really experienced. And normally they play without many mistakes, so it will be important to be there, like we did in the last games, really, really concentrated ourselves without mistakes in our defending behavior. And because Derby normally doesn't give away many chances, I think it's important to be really, really effective in using the chances tomorrow. That will be crucial for being successful. When I think about the last game against them, it was really for us difficult, because we played 120 minutes at the Emirates, and Derby was able to recreate. For us, it was the third game within 6 days, because we had so much load, and I think Derby had 8 or 9 games days without a game. And but it was a close game, so I think we were on the front foot in the beginning of the game, had several chances. I can remind Markus Tiepermann was one against one situation on the goalkeeper, and he hits a crossbar and the ball goes directly on the line and then outside of the goal. I got the feeling when we are able to score the first goal, we will win this game, but it came the other way around. So Derby was able with their first strike on our goal after 40 minutes or something like this, they were able to score, and then they sit back and defended everything, and to be honest, they played without mistakes, and it was difficult to turn the game around. So for that, it will be important for tomorrow to go in lead would be the best, and Derby won't give too many chances away, and we have to be really, really effective in our game, and really brutal and clinical in the finishing situations. And also, we know Derby normally doesn't need many chances. So in our home game, I think they had 3 chances and scored 2 times. And we have to be really, really effective in this game.
Is it sort of the 8 and 10 role that Morris would play? Is that where you envisage using him, that he's here?
I think he can play different roles. So normally, because he's technical, so full of ability, and he can score and he can assist, he played a lot on the number 10 position. In the recent years, pretty often on the number 8 position, but also when he can play on the number 6. So when he's a guy who's more, let's say, concentrated on defending, for example, for us, Alex Tete next to him, he can play the number 6 position as well, because he's then able to build up the game and play smart passes. And although the opponent is pressing, he's able to keep the ball and is not nervous under pressure. So he can play different roles, and it's good.
You didn't mention Marcus Edwards when you listed the new guys who have sort of had another week. Is he getting any closer to being involved? Because he's the one we sort of haven't really seen in it.
No, a lot of competition, because I just want to mention especially the midfield players, and Marcus was a bit longer together with us. That was the reason I didn't mention that he has a proper week. But yeah, he's an option. There's a lot of competition at the moment. It's not so easy to come into the 18 squad, because I just can have 16 field players for the games, and like I mentioned before, so this week we trained the complete week with 20 field players, and James Madison in the last two games as well, in the last two sessions as well, and for that a lot of competition, and he has to show that he wants to be in the squad, that he wants to be involved, and then he has got all chances.
Probably not a great question to ask, but is the squad a little bit bigger than you would have wanted at the moment?
No, not. I think in the beginning it was perhaps a bit too big in the beginning. But right now, I think several lads left us, and the number is really good. So it's just a situation that Tom is out right now, but all the other lads are fit. So when Matt Jarvis returns, and then we have Louis Thompson as well, who's out for 1.5 years. So I think in the moment it's really good, and it's good to have this competition, because it's quite good that each and every player has a feeling, on the training pitch I can't be there with 10% less or whatever. I have to be there to defend my position in the squad and my position in the starting lineup. It's a good situation, and you just have to take care sometimes that the competition is not too high, that they concentrate more on being good in the training pitch, and in comparison to be good on the pitch on the Saturdays. But I think in the moment we have a really good balance, and I'm really pleased with the situation.
Just two more quick ones. Did you notice, actually you did, that Rudy Gisted's red card was rescinded from Saturday? And your thoughts that he now won't serve any ban at all?
That's a bit crazy, because like I mentioned before, I think it was, he had a yellow card, and he was there with a sliding tackling, and I wouldn't say it was a red card. I watched it back, and I think a yellow card would be probably the right decision, because at least I didn't see a bad intention. So for that, I would agree that it was not a red card, but it was 100% a yellow card, and that would mean normally a yellow-red suspension. And for that, he would be out for the next game. But I think the rules are if the red card is denied, you can't be booked for the yellow red card or something like this. It's a bit tricky, but law is sometimes a bit tricky. And it is like, so for me, I'm totally fine. So I was just content that he has to go, leave the pitch in our game. So whatever happens right now, so I'm not involved, and everything's okay.
Brilliant. And finally, the FA Youth Cup, the under-18s had a great win on Wednesday, and I know you were there taking it in. Do those little things have a? Do they filter through to the first team? Obviously, a couple of them were there, and just in terms of the mood around the place.
Yes, I think it's a good sign of what we try to create here. So a really big togetherness not only in our group, but in the whole club. And I think it's important that there's a good relationship between the first team, the under 23, the under 18, and that all the players, also in the squad, like the under 18 or under 23, have the feeling, if we are there with good performances and hard working, there's a chance to be involved. And I think it's important that they have the feeling, the first team staff and the head coach and the sporting director are there with an eye on our performances of what we are doing. So I think it's important that they're It's a big distance, and it's not like it's too easy to go through the door. So it's not like I don't believe in praising young lads too much. I think it's also important to give them a sign. Okay, it's not one good game, and you're the new superstar or whatever. It's more like I said before, quality for me is performance over a longer period, and that's what they have to show, not only in one game and in many games, but. We have many examples that when they are there with good working and good performances, that there are all chances to be involved on our level, and we will follow them pretty concentrated.
Thanks, Daniel. Cheers.
Okay.
Thanks.
Good.